first candle we light is to remember those whom we have lost, loved, and lost. We pause to remember their name, their face, their voice, the memory that binds them to us in this season. May God's eternal love surround them.
The second candle we light is to redeem the pain of loss, the loss of someone who is very important to us, part of our lives, part of our own selves. Pause to gather up the pain of the past and offer it to God, asking that from God's hands we receive the gift of peace. Refresh, restore, renew us, O God, and lead us into your future.
The third candle we light is to remember ourselves this Christmas time. We pause and remember these past few weeks and months, the disbelief, the anger, the down times, the poignancy of reminiscing, the hugs and handshakes of family and friends, all those who stood with us. We give thanks for all the support we have known. Let us remember that dawn defeats darkness, life overcomes death.
The fourth candle is lit to remember our faith in the gift of hope which the Christmas story offers to us. We remember that God, who shares our life, promises us a place and a time of no more pain and suffering. Let us remember the one who shows the way, who brings the truth, and who bears the light.
And now from the 42nd Psalm, a psalm that speaks of challenge, being disquieted, and for a sincere desire of connection to God. Hear now the word. As a deer longs for flowing streams, so my soul longs for you, O God. My soul thirsts for God, for the living God. When shall I come and behold the face of God? My tears have been my food day and night, while people say to me continually, "Where is your God?" These things I remember as I pour out my soul, how I went with the throng and led them in procession to the house of God, with glad shouts and songs of thanksgiving. A multitude kept keeping festival, Why are you cast down, O my soul? Why are you disquieted within me? Hope in God, for I shall again praise him, my help and my God. My soul is cast down within me. Therefore I remember you from the land of Jordan and of Hermon, from Mount Mizar. Deep calls to deep at the thunder of your waterfalls. All your waves and your billows have gone over me. By day, the Lord commands his steadfast love, and at night his song is with me, a prayer to the God of my life. I say to God, my rock, why have you forgotten me? Why must I walk around mournfully? Because the enemy oppresses me. As with a deadly wound in my body, my adversaries taunt me, whilst they say to me continually, where is your God? Why are you cast down, O my soul? And why are you disquieted within me? Hope in God, for I shall again praise him, my help and my God. Let us join in singing The Bleak Midwinter, which is what hymn number?
Number 221, and we'll sing stanzas 1, 2, and 4.
Jesus had not yet come to the village, but was still at the place where Martha had met him. The Jews who were with her in the house, consoling her, saw Mary get up quickly and go out. They followed her because they thought that she was going to the tomb to weep there. But Mary came where Jesus was and saw him. She knelt at his feet and said to him, Lord, if you had been here, my brother would not have died. When Jesus saw her weeping, and the Jews who came with her also weeping, he was greatly disturbed in spirit and deeply moved. He said, "Where have you laid him?" They said to him, "Lord, come and see." Jesus began to weep. So the Jews said, "See how he loved him." I ask you just to think for a moment what it means to you that the scriptures tell us that Jesus weeps. Anyone would like to share a word or a thought? You may.
Jesus is a life that's kind of like mine.
God could weep at a place of sorrow, knowing that he was going to raise Lazarus really soon. That makes God feel closer to me. One willing to enter into the emotions. It's an aspect of the incarnation. Connecting into us where we live. Feels an important verse to me. Is it interesting to you that when Jesus has come on the scene and seen this, and yet it is when they turn and he says, "Where did they lay him?" And they said, "Come and see." They invite him to encounter and experience. That is the point where he begins to weep. Are there times in your life where you have noted it's not always necessarily the time that people expect when emotion strikes you? The offer of the experience to come and see, to experience, to be. That was the place that emotion overtook him. Wherever we are in our lives where emotion connects to us, that we experience the depths or the heights. Christmas is the promise that Jesus was incarnated to experience the whole of it with us, because he knows the fullness of the human experience. He knows her pains and her joys. He knows the other side. And still is with us in the moment. That is the power of the Christmas story. He Emmanuel, God with us. I invite anyone who desires to come and light a candle and have a field display while people come and light candles. You can light a candle for a person. You can say their name. You can say it to yourself. You don't have to say it aloud. You can say it for a situation, for a place of estrangement, for a place of pain. Just a candle for the hope of light that you would want. And I invite you to have your time to do that, or have your time just to reflect on the light increasing.
Thank you. singing Away in a Manger.
Number 217, verses 1 and 3.
The challenges of loss during the season for those from the tornado, for all those who've passed from COVID, for all the places where hurt is. We go out into the darkness, but we remember the promise that the darkness does not overcome the light. The light is greater. Go forth in the peace and the power that.